Let me take a sip of this because I need to calm my nerves. Hi guys, so I am finally back to do my April favorites video and I have all of my items ready to go. So let's just jump in. So I really don't have a lot of items this month, but I have some random, different, crazy kind of stuff in this video. So let's jump in. First off, I'm going to tell you dolls what I'm wearing on my lips and on my face, just in case anyone is wondering. The lipstick that I'm wearing is the YSL number 13, and this one is called Peach Passion. So it's like a peachy color, which looks like this. This isn't in my favorites, but it's what I'm wearing right now. And the gloss that I have on top is called Perennial High Style, and it's from MAC. It's just a peachy lip gloss. So that's what's on my lips. I will get into what's on my face a little bit later because one of the items is in my favorites. So let's just jump in. So first thing is the Fit Tea African Mango Complex Fat Burner, and this is what the bottle looks like. This is just like the Fit Tea. I know you dolls remember me doing the video. It's actual tea and you drink it. I was telling you dolls that it feels really soothing and everything like that. This is basically the same thing except for it's in a pill form, and it's like a capsule type of pill. The ones that have like the coating on them, so it doesn't taste nasty or anything like that. And I believe you're supposed to take 4 of these a day. I actually only take 2 and I take them in the morning. I feel like they do give you a lot of energy and I think they are a great detox. Except the only thing that you don't get with these is that soothing feeling that you get whenever you're drinking tea. But I find that these are very, very good and easy to take because sometimes I don't have time to fix tea and drink it. So I find that these are easy. You can just take it with you and, you know, you can be on the go. So it's really, really easy. And I really love these. And I think they work really good for getting rid of some of the bloating and everything like that. So definitely check these out. I will put the link down below. Let's do some other type of items. One of my favorite things this month is this new perfume that I got. This is Flower Bomb by Viktor & Rolf. And what made me actually love this scent is my scent bird. So here's my scent bird little packaging, and I was telling you dolls about this in one of my other videos. This is a subscription service where you actually get the actual real perfume, and in here this is Flower Bomb, and I've used it all the way down to here. So it's kind of like you get to test out high-end perfumes before you actually go to the store and buy them, and of course you pay a monthly fee and you get a different perfume every month of your choice. So I had Flower Bomb and I really loved it so much that I had to get the full-size perfume. So I've been loving this scent for the month of April. Really, really love it. And also another thing that I really love is this lotion from Bath & Body Works. This is the Cashmere Glow, the 24-hour moisture ultra shade body cream. So I really, really love this. It smells like a dream. It just smells so good. It has like a perfumey type of scent. It doesn't have a clean scent or like a fruity type of scent. It just has a really perfumey type of smell to it, and it just smells really good. Kind of has like some musky notes to it, and it just smells really, really good. I absolutely love this scent. Let's go ahead and do beauty items. So let's start off with face. This isn't actually one of my favorites this month, but I did want to show it because it's what I have on my face right now, and some of you dolls may actually notice a difference. And I feel like it is a little bit dark, but it kind of blends out and works okay. This is the MAC Face and Body Foundation. As you dolls know, I don't wear liquid foundations, but I've had this in my collection for quite some time. I bought it quite a long time ago and I wanted to try it out, but it really didn't match me. And I think it was more when I was a little bit more pale, so I really had trouble pulling it off. And this is in the color C6, but I decided to try it out today, and I was gonna mix it with the concealer to just make it a little bit more yellow for my skin tone. But I feel like when I put it on, it blended into my skin really well, and I think that it matches pretty good. So that's what I have on my skin today. And then also for my highlight, this is actually one of my favorite items. This is the Estee Lauder Signature 5-Tone Shimmer Powder. And this says that you can use it for your eyes, cheeks, or for your face. I use this product as a highlight, and it really reminds me of the Bobbi Brown Shimmer Bricks because it has all of these different tones in it. So it goes from like a golden white color to some champagne colors, and then it also deepens up into this brown shade. And I kind of just mix all the colors together and apply them on my cheek as a highlight. I'm actually wearing it today. I think this is so gorgeous. I just love it so much. And this will be really pretty as eyeshadow colors as well. I haven't tried it yet, but really, really love this. Also, another face item. This is the Makeup Forever Pro Sculpting Duo, and this is in the shade 2. This is the one that has the gold highlight color in it, and I've been absolutely loving this highlight color. It's just so gorgeous, and I haven't really used the bronzer, and I'll just do a quick swatch. So there it is right there, and I'll just do a quick swatch of the Estee Lauder really quick so you guys can see a comparison. So as you can see, the Estee Lauder is more of a rose gold tone. It kind of matches more into my skin tone but gives me a really nice glow, and this one is more golden, which is the Makeup Forever. The Estee Lauder is limited edition, and I picked it up from a CCO, but I have seen it on eBay, and it's reasonably priced. It's not too high or anything, so check it out there. I'll try to put a link down below to an eBay seller. So yes, I've been loving both of those highlights this month. And then also, as far as blush, I've really been loving my Ambient Lighting blush palette. And I usually use the middle shade the most, Incandescent Electra, and it's like a coral shade. And I also really like the other two shades as well. This one is like a deeper pink color, and then this one is like a really light pink color. So I really love this palette, and I like to use these blushes on top of other blushes just to give it a nice sheen. Or for days when I don't want a blush that's too harsh or anything, I'll just use this palette alone. So it's really, really pretty, and I absolutely love it. But let's do some eye products. Well, yeah, I don't have that many, but I've been loving my NARS palette, and this is the And God Created the Woman palette. This came out quite some time ago. I don't know if you can still pick it up, but one of my favorite tones in this palette is this brown shade in here, and this one is actually called Galapagos. This is a really popular brown shade. It's just a really nice brown, and it has some glitter in it. Really, really pretty color to wear in your crease. I'm wearing this color today in my crease. It's what I'm actually wearing on my lid, and this just gives you a really nice bronzy look. I don't know the name of it because they're not printed on the back. I just know Galapagos because it's a super popular color. But these NARS shadows are really, really nice, and I absolutely love this little palette. So next, I'm going to tell you guys about an eyeliner that I've been loving. I meant to actually show this in my last favorites video, but I forgot to show you. This is an Urban Decay cream or gel eyeliner, and this one is in the color Perversion, which is the black one. Super, super dark black, and this is like a really thick consistency. This really reminds me of the Inglot number 77 gel eyeliner. I believe it's number 77. But yes, I had that one before, and it dried out really fast. I feel like this one is a really dry texture, but it's not dried out to where I don't want to use it at all. And the way I like to use this is with my Inglot Duraline drops, and I love to place like a drop of this inside of the cream eyeliner before I use it, and it just really makes it glide on really nicely, and it doesn't tug at your eyes or anything like that. And I find that it lasts really, really long that way, and it's just easier to work with because it is more of a dry formula. So whenever you use the two together, it just gives you a really creamy formula, and it works really, really well because a lot of times I do have allergies, so in my inner corner my eyeliner will start to rub off, but whenever I use this I don't have that problem. It'll last all day even if my eyes get watery, so I really, really love that. So two other eye products are these mascaras, and these are the little mini trial sizes. You can get these like as samples, well, not as samples, but you know, like Sephora point perks and things like that. So this is the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara, and then this is also the Their Real mascara. I do also have these in the full size, but I've been using my little ones, and I really, really love them. And I like to apply these two together. I like to apply the Their Real first and then go on top of it with the Too Faced Better Than Sex. And I've been using this on my bottom lashes, and it makes them look really, really nice. And then at the top, I'll just use one or the other mascara because I always wear lashes, so I don't have to do the double. But it really just makes your lashes look really voluminous and long and everything, so I really like these two mascaras together. Let's get back into some face items that I forgot to show you guys. So one of the things that I've been liking to really use is the MAC matte gel, and this is what it looks like. It comes in a tube like this, and it's a really good primer, I feel like, but I don't feel like it really mattes you out completely. Like, this is called a matte gel, but I still get oily in my T-zone whenever I use this. But I think it works really good at smoothing the skin before you apply your concealer or whatever to your face. So I like it for that aspect of it, just to really smooth. But I don't feel like that it completely mattes out your skin and you won't get oily, because I still get oily whenever I use this. So for concealers underneath my eyes, what I've really been liking to use is my MAC Prep and Prime. And this one is in the color Bright Forecast. I have it on today, and I don't have another concealer mixed in with it at all. It's kind of like an orangey tone. I'll apply a little bit right there if you guys can see it. It's kind of like an orangey tone, but it's also very brightening, and I feel like it works great for my skin tone. And it's not too heavy or anything like that. It's really lightweight and it blends out nicely. It doesn't crease or anything. And this is just really, really nice, and I love it. And sometimes whenever I want to amp it up a bit and brighten it up just a little bit, I will add in some of this Select Cover Up Concealer. And this is also from MAC, and this is in the color NC42. Really, really nice combination. This is also a really lightweight concealer, and it doesn't feel heavy or anything. So I feel like these two work really good together to make it feel like it's not too heavy on your eyes or anything, like the Pro Longwear Concealer. So I really like those two together. And what I've been liking to use lately for my concealer is this brush. This is a MAC 234, and I like to apply my concealer and then I'll pat it out with this brush and also pat out around the edges, and it just blends in really nicely, and I don't have any creasing or anything like that. I don't swirl it or anything. I just kind of tap it, and I think this brush works really, really good for that. And then also to blend out the edges even more, as well as to set the concealer, I really love this brush. This is from a set that I got from CN Direct. Super, super cheap and inexpensive brushes, but the quality is really nice. And I'll just pat this around the edges to blend it out and also pick up some powder and set. So this brush is really nice, and I really love it for under the eyes because it's a tapered brush. So it can get right under your eyes really, really nicely in the creases and everything. So I really love this brush. And I believe you can get these in other colors, but I picked the blue ones. Also, a pair of lashes that I've really been loving this month are my Coco Lashes in the Style Goddess. These lashes are super, super gorgeous. If you guys want to see these lashes more close up and in a tutorial, I will link it down below. I did use these lashes in my Anaconda video. Really, really love these lashes. They don't look natural at all because they kind of like stick together, and they're really spiky, but I think they're really, really pretty and they give you a really glam look. So I love these lashes. The last thing of the beauty items that I have to show you dolls is this Mena facial cream, and it's like a brightening cream that you would use like for dark spots and things like that to kind of like lighten them up. So here's how it looks, and I purchased this off of either eBay or Amazon, one or the two, I don't remember. But I've seen some videos on it and people were saying that it really helps to like brighten up your skin and dark spots and things like that. So I had bought it quite a while ago, but I've been using it lately just on my dark spots, like not dark circles under my eyes, but on my recent makeup tutorial, I had a spot on my face. I believe it was on this side, and I've already faded that one because of me picking at my skin. So I faded it out by using this, and now I have one on this side from me picking on my face. So I've been using this at night, and I just kind of like dab it on, and then I'll let it sit overnight. And I feel like it works really good to brighten up dark spots. So I recommend this. I don't know if it'll work great for everybody, but this is what I've been using, and I think it works really good. And then lastly, I have a lipstick. This lipstick is by BH Cosmetics, and this is just like from their regular line of lipsticks. And this one is called Tea Time. I really love this lipstick. It's an everyday lipstick, and I apply it, and then I put a gloss on top, and it just gives you a really nice neutral pinky color. So there it is. If you guys can see that, it's just a really nice pink tone, and you can apply it more sheer or whatever. And then, of course, like I said, I put a gloss on top so it's not that pigmented whenever I wear it. So lastly, I have some food items. So one thing that I've really been loving this month is gummy bears, the ones that are by Haribo's. And I don't have any with me right now because I took my last pack with me to work today, and I ate most of them and I left the rest at work, so I can't show you those. But then another thing that I really have been loving is to drink my wine so that I can relax my nerves and calm down so I don't have to kill anyone. So yes, I've really been loving to drink my wine lately. And the wine that I've been liking is a different type of wine. And it's like a cheapy wine, but it's really good to me. So here is how the bottle looks. I brought it in here. This is a new bottle. I've already went through. This is my second bottle of this. So I really like this one. This is a strawberry Moscato, and this one is by Fruit Fantasy. So here's how it looks. I believe that's how you say it. And this is a strawberry Moscato. It has 6.5% of alcohol in it. if anyone is wondering, but I really just love the flavor of this. The one that I'm drinking right now is the peach flavor, and I don't particularly care for it too much, but I'm gonna finish off the bottle. But I really, really love the strawberry one, and like I said, that's my second bottle that I purchased, so I really do like it. I also love like regular Moscato and pink Moscato as well. So those are like my choices of wines that I've been drinking, but I did try out this cheaper one whenever I was at the grocery store. It kind of just caught my eye because of the label and everything, and I was like, strawberry Moscato, I've never tried it. So I was like, let me try this out. And I think it is so much better because I used to actually like to drink Arbor Mist, those type of fruity wines, and those made my stomach hurt so bad. And the peach one kind of does that to me too a little bit if I drink it too fast. But the strawberry one doesn't do that to me. So I really love the strawberry one. I definitely recommend it. And I think they had a watermelon one also, but I have not tried that one. So yeah, that is it for my April favorites video. If you guys have any questions, leave them down below. And don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe. Bye, dolls.